Hello everyone, good morning, welcome to maths class. So in this class we are going to discuss about IMO. So already we have completed chapter 1. In this class we are going to learn our chapter 2, that is addition. Addition means what, children? We have to put the things together. Adding means put the things together or joining things or combining things. So the numbers which we are adding are called addends. What are called addends, children? The numbers which we are added. So that means if I add 9 plus 3. So I am adding 9 and 3. So these two numbers we will call it as addends. What are they, children? Addends. A-D-D. Add. E-N-D-S. Ends. Addends. The numbers which we are adding are called addends. The symbol of the addition is plus. What is the symbol of addition, children? P-L-U-S, plus. Whenever we have this symbol, that means we should add the things together. What we have to do if you have this symbol? We need to add the things. Now, the answer which we get, after adding is called sum. So, the answer which we get after adding is called sum. So, this answer is called S-U-M, sum. What we will call it as, children? That is called sum. S-U-M, sum. So, if I ask you to find out sum for the given numbers, 24, 12. So, you have to find the sum. So, if anyone asks you to find sum, means what you have to do? When will you get sum, children? When after addition, when will you get? After addition, we are going to get our sum. So, if anyone asks you find the sum of the given numbers, means blindly you have to add the numbers. So, we have methods to add, yes? So, we can add the numbers by using column method. Column method is nothing but we have to arrange the numbers according to their place values, children. So here, which numbers are there, which type of numbers are these? These are two-digit numbers. When we have single digits, we can add the numbers by using our fingers easily. Yes, children? Yes. But when we have two-digit numbers, it is difficult to add us. Yes, it is difficult to add. So, when we are like these numbers, we have to use column method, that is, so, we have to arrange the numbers according to their place values. In the two-digit numbers, we have two place values. Those are ones and tens. What are they? Ones and tens. So, in this 24, how many tens are there and how many ones are there, children? So, ones, tens. So, you need, first number is represents tens and the second number represents ones. So, two tens, four ones makes 24. So, if you want to get 24, means what you need to take, children? You have to take two tens and plus 4 ones. Yes, 2 tens, 4 ones makes 24. So, 2 under tens place value 2 and under ones place value 4. 2, 4, 24. Next, move to the 12. So, ones and tens. How many tens are there and how many ones are there in 12, children? There are 1 ten and 2 ones in our 12. So, you have to write under the tens place value 1 and 2 ones place value 2. Now, we have to add. So, what is the symbol of addition, children? Plus. So, now we have to add from left side, from right side we have to add. From which side we have to add, children? From right side, that is from our one side. So, 4 plus 2. So, 4 in mind, take two fingers. Big number we have to keep in our minds and take small number as our fingers. 4 after 5, 6. So, the answer is 6. Under 1's place value, 6. And then move to the tens and add tens numbers. So, 2 and 1. So, 2 in mind, take one finger, 2 after 3. So, what is our answer, children? 36. The sum of 24 plus 12 is 36. Sum means what you have to do, children? You have to add the numbers. What you have to do, sum means? You need to add the numbers. Now have double digit numbers 14. So how many tens and how many ones you need to make 14 children? We need to take 1 10 and 4 ones makes 14. 1 10, 4 ones makes 14. That means first place represents tens place value and the second place represents ones. Yes? So like this you have to add the numbers. Addition means you have to put the things together. That means you have to add the two numbers. So if you have two numbers, we can add like this. But if we want to find the sum of three or four numbers, what we have to do? See children. See, I want to add 12, 16, 11. Yes? So I need to add these numbers. That means I want to find the sum of these numbers. So what you have to do, children? You have to add them by using column method. How can we add them, children? By using column method. Means we have to arrange the numbers according to their place values. So ones and tens, all are two digit numbers. So in the two digit numbers, we have two place values. Tens place value and ones place value. First number represents tens place value and the second number represents ones place value. So tens under 1, ones under 2, tens under 1, ones under 6 and then tens under 1, ones under 1. So we have to arrange the numbers according to their place value. That means we need to line up the numbers one by one. So if you have more numbers also you can add. If you have more numbers, so which number is this? This is single digit number. In the single digit number we have only ones place value. So under the tens place value we can leave or we can keep 0 and the tens place value, ones place value we have 2. So then we can add the number. So now we are finding three numbers sum. So see, keep plus. So 2 plus 6. So 6 in mind, which number is big here? 6. So 6 in mind, take 2 fingers. 6 after 7, 8. So now 8 in mind, take 1 finger. One more number is there. So 8 in mind, take 1 finger, 8 after 9. So 9. Now 1 plus 1 plus 1. So 3. 39. The sum of these three numbers is equal to 39. The sum of these numbers equal to 39. So like this you have to add the numbers by making them line up. By writing numbers. So the numbers which we are adding are called addends. The answer which we get after adding is called sum. The symbol of the addition is plus. Yes? So now I have 48 children. Yes? I am adding something to the 48. So the result is 48. Have you understood? So I have 48. I have added something to 48. After adding, the result is 48. That means which number? How much did I add to 48 to get 48? Yes. When we will get 48 children? So when we will get same number as our answer? When we add 0 to any number or any number to 0, the answer is same. So that means I have added 0. What did I add at children? 0. 48 plus dash is equal to 48. When we add 0 to any number or any number to 0, the answer will be same. Yes? Now, I have added 36 plus dash is equal to 36. So, what did I added? Yes, 0. So, when we add 0 to any number, the answer will be same. The answer remains same. Understood? Now, I'm going to explain one more thing, children. See, 12 plus dash is equal to 13. How much did I add it to 12 to get 13? Yes, 12 after 13. So we have to count the numbers. 1 we have added. So 12 after number is 13. So When we add 1 to any number or any number to 1, when we add any number to 1 or 1 to any number, the answer is after number. The answer is after number. That means when we add 0 to any number, the answer is same. When we add 1 to any number or any number to 1, is answer after number. The answer is after number. Have you understood, children? Everyone? Yes. Now, can you find the sum of, find the sum of smallest two-digit number, smallest two-digit number and greatest two-digit number? Greatest two-digit number. So, find the sum of smallest two-digit number and the greatest two-digit number. Here, I didn't give any numbers in this question. Did I give any questions in this? So, I did not mention any numbers in this question. But I gave you one clue, children. Find the smallest two-digit number. Sum of smallest two-digit number and greatest two-digit number. Means, what is smallest two-digit number, children? Yes, 1, 0, 10. 1, 0, 10. The smallest two-digit number is 10. And the greatest two-digit number is 99. The greatest two-digit number is 99. Now, what we have to do, children? We have to add the numbers. Sum means we should add. So, put the symbol of sign. Symbol of addition. Now, 0 plus 9. When we add 0 to any number or any number to 0, the answer is same. So, 0 plus 9 is 9. Now, 1 plus 9. So, big number in mind. Take one finger. 9 after 10. So, answer is 10. So, 109. So, the answer is 109. What is answer, children? 109. So, the greatest small two-digit number and the smallest two-digit number sum is 109. Have you understood? When we have like these clues, we have to do like this, children. Now, I'm giving one more problem, children. See, 1 plus 3, comma, 2 plus 4, comma, 6 plus 1. So, I have given these numbers. So, you have to arrange these numbers by smallest to greatest. You have to arrange the numbers from smallest to greatest. So, what you have to do? So, from smallest to greatest means here we have two numbers. That means first we have to find the sum of the numbers, because in between two numbers we have symbol of addition. So, if you have addition symbol, you need to add the numbers and you have to find the sum of that number. So, 1 plus 3. What is 1 plus 3, children? 4. When we add 1 to any number, we will get after number. So, 4. 2 plus 4 is equal to 6. Now, 6 plus 1 is equal to 7. So, the sum of 1 plus 3 is 4. The sum of 2 plus 4 is equal to 6. And the sum of 6 plus 1 is equal to 7. So, here we got the numbers here. Now, you have to arrange the numbers from smallest to greatest. Or greatest to smallest means according the order you have to add. Yes, according the order. Increasing order means you have to write from small number to big number. Decreasing, descending order or decreasing order means you have to write from big number to small number. So, which is the minimum number here? Can you find the minimum number, children? Minimum number means less number. Which is less number here? Smallest number you have to find among these numbers. That is called minimum number. And maximum number means? Yes. Maximum means greatest number. Which is greatest number? 7 is greatest number. So, 7 is greatest. number, maximum number. 4 is minimum, smallest number, so 4 is called minimum number. So what you have to do means you have to do the questions from 1 to 20 children. So how many questions you have to do? 1 to 20 questions. Just you have to add the numbers. How you have to add? You have to add the numbers from ones place to right side of the numbers. Ones place, then tens place. Yes? So like this you have to add. So how can you add the numbers by using abacus? So now you have these two numbers, children. So you have to show the sum of these two numbers by using abacus. So see, ones. Abacus. So ones place value, tens. So from right side we have to write every time place values, ones and tens. Now plus, I'm adding one more abacus to this first abacus. Ones and tens is equal to dash. Means I'm going to draw some beads on these place values. Yes. Now what you have to do, children? You have to draw one more abacus to the answer. Now write place values, ones, tens. Now on this abacus and on this abacus we have to take ones, tens place value beads. So on this tens place how many beads we have? One. So you are drawing one. And this abacus on the ones tens place, which how many beads we have? One more bead. So add. So two beads are there on the tens place value. And next move to the ones place value. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you have to draw 8 things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So like this. 2, 8, 20. Yeah, the sum of these two abacuses is 28. So like this you have to add the numbers by using abacus also. You have to count the tens place value beads and ones place value beads and the combine them. Addition means combining. You have to add them. You have to join them. So everyone complete from first question to 20 questions and read question one or two times, children, then go through the options. So complete your volume, note, complete your book and send it through the WhatsApp, children.